Okay, good evening, students. We're about to start with today's class. Okay, give me a chance. Okay. Here we go. Okay, I'm gonna wait for a while because of the students, right? Okay. Okay, good evening, Miguel.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you today?
Very busy.
Okay, nice, cool, good job.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Good evening, Daisy. Okay, I think Daisy is.
Good evening.
Good evening, how are you today?
Not my mother. Ahí bien.
Hey, more or less. Okay, Daisy, really nice.
Aquí voy a estar escuchando.
Okay, no problem. Are you still sick?
Sí.
Okay. Okay, don't worry. Just listen.
Okay, thank you.
This class. But when I gonna say your name, please turn on the webcam and say I am here, teacher.
Right? Okay.
Okay. Jose Angel, good evening.
Good evening. Very good.
Okay, nice. Cool. Okay, Miguel, turn on the webcam, please.
Right now.
Yeah, we want to see you, right? Okay, cool. Thank you, Miguel. Nice. Okay, guys, what's your day, Miguel? Did you work today?
Pero
okay.
Video is
okay, good. Okay, nice. Thank you. Okay, we're gonna wait for a while for the rest of the students, right? If you got a, I don't know if you got a question about the last topic from last week. If you got a question about the past tense, please let me know. I'm gonna be for you, right? Jose Angel, no tiene dudas ahí del pasado simple.
No, teacher.
No, right?
No.
Okay, cool, amazing. Really good. Okay, we're gonna start in a minute, right?
Okay.
Daisy, what about you? Do you have a question about the previous classes? The past simple tense?
No, teacher.
No question, everything was clear. Oh. Okay. Okay, really, really good. If you don't have any question, it's okay, right? Okay, students. Okay, give me a minute. Gabriela, good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you today?
I'm fine.
Okay, you look tired. Like this. I want to sleep.
Yes.
Yeah, sure. Okay, very good. We're going to start with today. Time, right? Okay. Okay. Okay, guys. Basically, we are about to finish this module, right? Right now, we're gonna start with accounting. Accounting, right? Esto a algunos les va a gustar más que a otro, pero es genial, right? We're gonna learn something new. Mary, got this.
I like it.
Yeah, sure, I know. Okay, you're gonna teach us, right? Mary going to be our teacher. Right? Okay, cool. Good evening, Jorge. How are you today?
Fine, teacher.
Okay, nice. Cool. Okay. Good evening, Marlon. How are you?
Good evening, teacher. Fine, teacher. Fine, teacher.
Okay, nice. Cool. What about you, Fabrizio? How are you today?
Good evening, teacher. I'm fine, teacher.
Okay.
Very cool.
Very good. Nice to see you. Okay, we're going to start with the class because of the time, right? And here we go. We're going to start unit number 4. But before to start with this, we're going to make a feedback about the previous classes. Vamos a hacer un pequeño retroalimentación de las clases anteriores. Yeah, Marlon. Questions? Okay.
You may teach it. Question. Cuando significa pichai.
What does it mean? What?
Ay, pichai. ¿Qué significa eso, teacher?
Don't be shy.
Ah, eso, eso, correcto, eso, eso.
Don't be shy. No sean tímidos. No sean tímidos.
Don't. ¿Cómo se escribe, teacher?
Don't be shy. Okay.
Don't be shy.
Yeah, like this. Okay. Don't be shy. Like this.
Ah, don't be shy. Ah, be shy. Okay.
Eso usted lo puede contractar acá. Si lo contractamos.
Wow. Ah, okay. O sea que chai, chai es tímido.
Chai es tímido o que le es penoso.
Ah,
okay, it's
casi clear. Casi para terminar el curso, casi para terminar el curso entendí que era eso, dice.
Ah. Okay,
thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay, you're welcome. Okay, Okay, let's see, we're going to make a feedback. Vamos a hacer una pequeña retroalimentación acerca de las clases de la the last week. It was the simple tense. A simple tense, right? At the beginning, at the very beginning, we were talking about the verb. Hablábamos del verbo to be en pasado. Was and were, right? Was and were, the verb be in the past. Then we were talking about auxiliary, did or didn't, as a questions and as a negative way. Also, we're gonna use regular verb que solo agregamos ed. We add ed. Las pronunciaciones correctas para eso era it and that, right? And then we were discussing about irregular verbs. Son los verbos que got a change, right? Que tenían un cambio. Change. Okay. What I said? Okay. Let's see. And right now we're gonna... necesito ver si everybody understand this. You don't have any question about this? No questions?
No.
Okay. Really good. Okay, if you don't have any questions, you're gonna give me examples according to the pictures. Me van a dar unas ejemplos de acuerdo a las pictures que van a ir apareciendo. Yo solo le voy a decir si es verb be, auxiliary, regular verb or irregular verb, right? Okay, ready? Aquí vamos. Here we go. Okay, let's see. Okay. Marlo, can you give me an example using this place with the past simple tense using the verb be in the past? Was and were.
I was gym last week.
Okay, very good. Ahora Marlon con un irregular verbs, con un verbo irregular, son los que cambian totalmente. Podría ser ir, go. You can use go.
I went to gym.
I went to the gym, really good. Okay, Marlon. Congratulations, really nice, like this, right? Okay, let me see, what about this one? Esta is for Jorge, right? Jorge. Okay.
I work.
Yep.
In the bank last month.
Okay, very good, nice. Okay, right now, if you can give me an example using was or were.
Where were you last weekend?
Okay, where were you last weekend? Yeah, really good, nice. Thank you, Jorge. Good job. I like it. Okay, the last examples. Who wants to do it, right? ¿Quién se quiere acordar ahí de los años maravillosos? Okay. Okay, Mary.
I am.
Okay. Daisy, go ahead.
I am good. Oh, was a student. O fui un buen estudiante, no sé qué.
Okay, Daisy. Daisy, remember that you can give me an example using the past simple tense. You can talk about the past. Go ahead, again.
Fui, was.
Fui. Okay. Fui un estudiante, sí, was.
Ajá.
Yeah. Ajá. How do you say that?
I was.
Yeah.
good student.
A good student, really good, nice. Thank you, Daisy, nice. In that case, Daisy telling us about was and were, right? The verb be in the past. Really good job, Daisy, nice.
Okay, thank you.
Congratulations. Okay, remember guys that all the time that we're gonna use the past simple is simple, right? Simple like a pound francés. Was and were, fue o estuve, fui o estuve. O si yo did and didn't, we can use regular and irregular verbs. It did, and in this case, it changed its root. Okay, really good. And the last one. Okay, who wants to play? Lo que se perdieron este año. Okay. Okay, go ahead. Who wants to do this exercise? Mary, ready?
Okay, I went to the beach last vacation.
Okay, really good. Really honest, right? Mary es muy honesta, así que that's right. Thank you, Mary. Really good job. Okay, that's it for this, right? These topics. I don't know if somebody got a question about the past simple tense. No questions? All right. Very good. Nice. Good job. Okay. Good evening, Carlos, Alfonso. How are you today? Okay. Okay. Nice. Okay, really early. Okay, nice. Tatiana, good evening. How are you today?
Good evening, teacher.
Okay, how are you?
More or less.
Okay, more or less, right? Okay, thank you. Carlos Mejia, good evening. How are you? Okay, Carlos.
Hi, teacher. Good night.
Okay. How are you? How are you, Carlos Mejia?
Oh, very good, teacher.
Okay, nice. Good job. Okay, thank you, boy. Okay, hey, Carlos René, how are you today?
Fine, teacher.
Okay, you? Nice. Cool. I'm really good. Nice. Happy to see you today. Okay, let's see. I know today is, you know, Monday. Anybody knows we're gonna look like this. We want to do something like this, but we need to learn English, right? So that's why I'm here and you are here too. Let's get started with today's class. We got two topics for today's class. The first one, it will be counting vocabulary. About the second one, let me read Miguel Lopez, can you help me to read the second topic?
Okay, say counting vocabulary, how to use so and such.
And such, really good, nice. Okay, today we're gonna see how to use this and this, right? Okay, and we get two objectives we do all the time. The first one, Tatiana, can you help me to read the first one, please?
It's an objective, a specific. Participant will be able to describe financial. Sorry. Financial activities that my company or some else.
Has. Really good. Thank you, Tatiana. Nice. Cool. Okay, Carlos Mejia, the second objective, please. Go ahead.
Objective. At the end of class, participant will be able to know how to use so and such.
So and such. Really good. Okay, so thank you. Thank you, Carlos. Okay, guys, let's continue with this. Okay, here we go. And we're gonna have some useful words for today's class. At the very beginning, we're gonna see what does it mean so. Do you know what's the meaning of this word? What does it
entonces
mean? Entonces, okay, you're really good.
Así.
Como de mucho.
Okay, okay, thank you, Marilyn. Okay, really good. We don't know, right? Fabricio said, entonces, Mary said, tan, como de mucho, como de very, right? Okay, okay, let's keep. What about such? Such. Asking Google Translator. Okay.
Taldis.
Taldis. Okay.
Como una medida más o menos.
Como una medida.
He escuchado la frase such an amazing person.
Okay, okay.
Según entiendo es como una persona muy asombrosa, entonces
okay, okay, okay. Idea. Very good. Nice. Thank you, Mary. Okay, in this case, guys, it's really easy. Casi aquí Gabriela nos ha dado las respuestas. Significan tan. Pero en este caso, so, I'm going to explain you this. So significa entonces y también tan. No tan del fresco, right? Tan de tan genial de alguna cosa. Le damos un énfasis, right? We're going to give to the adjective an emphasis. Vamos a darle un énfasis a ese adjetivo. Por ejemplo, si hablamos que alguien es bonito o bonita, vamos a utilizar un énfasis muy bonito, muy bonita, y así otros adjetivos calificativos que podemos denotar. Entonces, so, ¿cuándo va a ser entonces? So es entonces cuando lo utilizamos nada más para dar un respiro. For example, so students, ese es entonces, es un respiro. Estoy pensando, I'm thinking what I'm gonna say. Estoy pensando qué voy a decir, right? No es que me lo estoy inventando, sino que necesito ahí un brief, un respiro. Okay, pero in this case we're gonna see so and such. Básicamente, cuando significa tan, an emphasis of these two words, right? Okay, thank you, Mary and Fabrizio. Really nice work. Okay, Marlon, do you have a question?
Question, teacher. Y cuando decimos, ¿cómo estás? Decimos, so.
Ah, okay. ¿Cómo? Okay, thank you, Marlon. Let's see this. Okay. This one, right? So. Okay, this expression is, how can I say this? Is informal answer, right? Es una respuesta informal que decimos así con nuestros cheradas, nuestros brothers, and something like that. How are you? How's it going? So. Más o menos. Es como decir more or less, más o menos. Acá estamos utilizándolo informalmente, ¿sí, Marlon? Cuando decimos so, más o menos, por no decir, more or less, muy largo. Entonces lo hacemos más pequeño, ¿sí? En ese caso sí, pero es informal. Entonces lo formal es decir, okay, Marlon, today we want to start with today's class and we have this objective and this and this and this. Right? So, who wants to participate? Okay, ese so es entonces... un respiro, a veces no significa nada, solo es un respiro. Sí, cuando decimos so, double so, es más o menos, pero es informal. That's informal, right? And cuando lo vamos a poner a la par de un adjetivo, que ya lo vamos a ver, va a significar an emphasis. So pretty. So, I don't know what you want to say, right? Okay, that's it. Okay, Marlon, it's okay. Okay, cool.
Thank you, teacher. Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. Okay, what about this one? Balance sheet. Okay, what is the meaning of this word?
Hoja de balance.
Balance general.
Yeah, sure. Balance general, right? Okay. Ahí algunos tienen una sonrisa enorme, enorme, y otros ahí, oh, teacher, really? Okay. But today, in my case, I am an English teacher, but I'm going to show you the meaning of each one of the words. Vamos a explicarle las palabras y el significado de cada una de ellas. If Mary help us, we're gonna teach you how to make a balance sheet, right? Later on. Okay, cool. Okay, and then we're gonna have cash flow. Cash flow. What does it mean this?
Flujo de efectivo.
Flujo de efectivo.
Yeah, flujo de efectivo. Okay, very good. Flujo de efectivo. Okay, guys. What does it mean, flujo de efectivo? ¿Qué es eso de flujo de efectivo, teacher? I don't understand that. Ajá. You got the answer.
En la empresa, teacher, ¿cómo se usa, por ejemplo, el dinero que hoy compramos? Que compramos una impresora, que pagamos a los proveedores y luego nos quedó unos $1,000. Es el dinero que se está usando a diario en el movimiento de la empresa.
Okay, that's good. Okay, nice. What about you, Gabriela?
Lo mismo que dijo la compañera ahí. Es como... Es que exactamente el dinero, el efectivo que se tiene en la empresa, cómo se ha usado en un periodo determinado.
Okay, cool, really good job. Okay, we're gonna learn a lot of things about accounting. Okay, good. Okay, we got a balance sheet, cash flow, such, balance sheet, cash flow. Okay, you don't have any problem with this, the pronunciation of this word? No problem? Okay, nice. This one, it's gonna be a kind of weird because you got to say shit. No otra palabra, right? It's shit. Ahí con mí. I'm gonna repeat it this because it can be a misunderstanding. Puede haber un malentendido. Este es shit. Con mí. Shit. Okay. Yeah. Nor E, right? No es la otra. Es la otra. Okay, that's good. Okay, but right now we're gonna have the attendance list. Okay, let's see. Okay, guys, when you hear your name, please say present teacher. I'm here, right? Okay, let me see. Okay, here we go. 34, yeah. Okay, sí, Carlos Enrique Martínez Genoves.
Teacher, present.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Wendy Saraí Bonilla Ordóñez. No. She's not here. Right now we're gonna continue with José Ángel. Okay.
I hear, teacher.
José Ángel Santo Martínez, really good, thank you. Gabriela Mary Zamora Orellana.
Present, teacher.
Really good. Okay, Jorge Alberto Ortiz Molina.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Thank you. Carlos Alfonso Alvarado Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Fernando de Jesús Rodríguez. Ok, Carlos Antonio Mejía Hernández.
Assistant teacher.
Ok, thank you. William Alexander Martínez Enríquez.
Present teacher.
Thank you, William. So, okay, Miguel Ángel Alexander López Crespín.
Present teacher.
Really nice. Marlon Ernesto Rodríguez Sandoval.
Present teacher.
Good. Rodrigo Alexander Maravilla. Clarita, Daisy Elizabeth Recinos Álvarez.
Present teacher, I am here.
Okay, really good. Tatiana Ivonne Torres. Okay, thank you, Tatiana. Marvin Ernesto Los Campos.
No, no.
Okay, Carlos René Herrera.
Present teacher.
Okay, really good. Fabricio Alexander Jiménez Herrera.
Here, teacher.
Okay, really good. Fabricio, you're gonna be the big boss, right? Okay, nice. Okay, Carlos, you're on the webcam. We want to see you. Don't be shy. Okay, that's it. Okay, guys, right now we're gonna continue with this, right? Okay, let's see. Today class, we're gonna see how to use so and such. So and such. We're gonna use as a pattern, right? And all the time that we're gonna use so, que significa tan, right? Tan en español, va a ir precedido de un adjective. ¿Se saben algunos adjectives? Adjectives?
Yes.
Okay, tell me one.
Really?
Pretty? Yeah, okay, that's it. What else? ¿Qué otro?
Far.
Sad. Sad. Okay, okay, that's good. Sad, what else?
Intelligent.
Intelligent, really good.
Happy.
Smart.
Smart. And so on, right? Yes, really nice. Okay, let's
shining
t-shirt.
Shining. Shining. Okay, good. Yeah, sure.
Beautiful.
Beautiful, yeah. Very good.
Beautiful.
Okay, thank you, Jose Angel. Okay, I know that you understand adjective, right? Ahora comprendo que sí, ya sabemos que es adjective. That's nice. Okay, let's see what the meaning and how to use it. Okay, the meaning is basically the same as very. Básicamente significa lo mismo que very. Muy o tan. ¿Han escuchado? Very good. Very nice. Very no sé qué. And so on, right? Y seguimos usando very. Okay. Entonces, ese very significa muy bien. Y tan también. Okay. We can use in a positive or negative situations. Podemos utilizarlo en la forma positive or negative, right? Positiva y negativa. Okay. But let's see the difference between these two meaning of this, right? Okay. Let's see. Básicamente, so significa lo mismo que very, y lo vamos a utilizar después de un adjective. Okay, but let's see, all of these, it means the same. Estos dos significan lo mismo, such and so. But what's the difference? ¿Cuál es la diferencia a la hora de utilizarlo? Let's see. As you see, such, we're going to use plus an article, plus an adjective, plus a noun. Okay, this is almost the same. Aquí se usa en la misma forma. Very es lo mismo que such or so. Okay, let's see an example. Veamos los ejemplos para tener un mayor entendimiento sobre esto. So, básicamente, solo va a ir precedido de un adjective, right? De un adjetivo. Pero such va a llevar un noun, un nombre. Veamos el ejemplo. Fabricio, can you read the first one, please?
That food was so delicious.
Okay, can you help me to read the first one from the second square?
That was such delicious food.
Okay, Fabricio, can you see a difference between both sentences? A difference?
Yes, la primera, ¿cómo se llama? Se omite, se utiliza la palabra o el alimento para referenciarlo primero.
Okay.
Que la otra se lleva al final.
Okay, at the end, right? Okay, uh-huh. Thank you, Fabricio. Este food, que es alimento o comida, es un noun, es un nombre. Nombre que se está refiriendo a alimentos, right? Okay, what's happened here? So delicious. ¿Qué pasa con esta comida?
Estaba muy deliciosa.
Muy buena. Estaba muy o tan deliciosa, como se escuche mejor. Ok, pero en este caso dice que esa, what?
Esa fue una muy deliciosa comida.
Ok, muy bien, Tatiana, really good. Ok, what happened here? If you see, the emphasis los tenemos en los dos, so and such. But the emphasis is different in both. Tenemos el énfasis en los dos, pero cada uno tiene su énfasis en diferente forma. ¿Cómo así? Vamos a utilizar so más un adjetivo. Nada más. Si tiene un nombre, entonces tendríamos que utilizar such. ¿Se comprende eso? Si tiene un nombre. Vean acá. Tiene un nombre. Nombre, nombre, noun. Acá, adjective, adjective, adjective. Y ahí se queda. Adjective. Right? Okay, let's see. The second example here, Carlos Mejía. Can you help me to read it, please?
Hi. My coworkers are so nice.
Yeah, this one.
My coworkers are so nice people.
Nice people, let's see. This is almost the same. Este es casi lo mismo que el anterior, solo que acá, ¿qué cambia? Toda la estructura es igual, pero at the end we got a noun. Tenemos un nombre. Acá dice, my coworkers are so nice. Carlos Mejía, en español.
Mis compañeros son buenos.
Ok.
Mis compañeros de trabajo son buenos.
Son muy buenos, son muy buenos.
Son muy buenos. So. Okay. Y mis compañeros son muy buenas personas.
Muy buenas personas. Ok, really good. What's happened here? Aquí agregamos people. Como agregamos people, tiene un noun, an extra word. Esa palabra extra tenemos que utilizar such. Es el mismo énfasis, se puede utilizar, pero si agregamos un nombre acá, tenemos que utilizar such, right? Ok, let's continue with this example. Yeah, tell me.
Sorry teacher, o sea, excuse me. Si vamos a cerrar con un adjetivo, so. Si vamos a cerrar con un nombre en sustantivo, such.
Such, yeah. Yeah, really good. Okay, okay, let's go to the formula here, right? Acá tenemos la formula, right? So plus adjective. Ahí, murió. But in this case, we got a such. Podemos encontrar un article. ¿Cuál es el article? A or an, or incluso da, T-H-E, plus an adjective, plus a noun. Cuando tenemos un complemento mayor, que no sea solo el adjetivo, sino que agregamos un nombre, un artículo, vamos a utilizar such, right? Okay, you got it? Yeah, sure, I hope so. Okay, let me see, Tatiana, continue with this one.
That the Smith was so awful.
Awful, yeah.
That was such an awful Smith.
Smell.
Smell.
Yeah, really good. Thank you, Tatiana. As you see, it's happened the same. We got it so awful. Estaba como, right? And in this case, we add a noun. Agregamos un nombre que es huelía, un poco extraño, right? Okay, and the last one that we have is, it's so cold today. Está muy frío ahora. Este today is not a noun, por eso podemos agregarlo, porque no es un nombre, por eso se usa por so. But in this case, yeah, it is such a cold day. Day, si es un noun, right? Es el nombre de, like a día, right? Yes, really good. I don't know if you got a question about this. I think it's easy. Está fácil, ¿verdad? How do you use so and such? Okay, let's see more use of this so and such. Veamos algunos otros usos que tiene so and such. Basically, so boring. So quickly. What is boring? Teacher, I'm boring.
Aburrido.
Aburrido, right? Like my classes. Okay, that's good. So boring. Aburrido. So quickly.
Rápido.
Yeah, very good. So many people. So many people.
Muchas personas.
Okay, muchas personas. So few friends.
Algunos amigos.
Okay, really good. So much work.
Mucho trabajo.
Yeah. Okay, so little time.
Poco tiempo.
Muy poco tiempo.
Very good. So good that. Okay.
Muy bueno en esto.
Muy bueno en eso. Okay, that's good. Nice. Cool. Okay, as you see here, todo eso está comprendible. Es decir, acá, so boring, so quickly, so good, hasta acá. But what happened here? Acá habíamos dicho que so se va a utilizar si no llevaba un nombre, right? Pero acá sí lo lleva. What happened here? ¿Qué está pasando acá? Something weird, right? Algo extraño, así que vamos a aclararlo right now. Cuando tengamos many or much, many para cosas contables y much para cosas incontables, sí podemos utilizar esos nombres. Porque ahí, por obligación, decimos, how much money, cuánto dinero. How much sugar, cuánta azúcar. Entonces, el how much, el solito, cuánto, tenemos que agregar algo. Entonces, acá sí podemos agregar el nombre. Solo exclusivamente en el caso de many, much, few, and little, que son los countable and uncountable. De ahí el resto, solo el adjective. Porque estos no son adjetivos, solo son contables. Les especifico porque usted va a decir, ok, teacher, but you tell me que no le agregara so, se llevaba una noun. Y acá se lleva un noun. So that's why I'm trying to explain this right now. Si lleva los countable or uncountable words, many, much, few, little, yes, you can use a noun. Aquí sí vamos a ocupar un noun, porque many no nos dice mucho, solo so many, what? We had to add a noun, right? Especialmente en este caso. Pero si solo utilizamos adjetivos, solo el adjetivo, so boring, so quickly. Okay, but right now we're gonna go to such. This is almost the same. Esto sí ya es lo mismo que vimos anteriormente. Such a surprise. Such as good concert. Yep. Aquí tenemos un article. Un artículo. A. A. And good concert. And compliments, right? Such nonsense. Such easy work. Such slow workers. Such a beautiful day. As you see here, we add a noun. Este such, si es más fácil, porque sabemos que tenemos que agregar a compliment, un nombre, un artículo, whatever you want, right? Okay, everything is clear? Or you got a question about this? No questions? Are you sure? Okay, nice. If you don't have any questions, we're gonna go to see some example here in order to make a deeper analysis about so and such. Okay, let's get a start with the first example, right? Okay, let's see, Miguel, go ahead with this one. In English, then translate it into Spanish, and then tell us why you put it here so. Okay, go ahead.
Okay. It is so necessary for the company.
Okay.
In Spanish, translate, era necesario para la compañía. Era muy necesario.
Okay, para la
compañía o para la empresa.
Okay, really good. So in this case, Miguel, why do we use so instead of such? ¿Por qué utilizamos so acá?
Porque después iba a objetivo.
Yeah, really good. Y acá, esto no es un nombre, ¿verdad? Esto no es un nombre, hasta aquí hay un nombre, pero ya perdió acá la estructura. Ok.
Pero ya he parado por acá.
Yeah. For the company, right? Okay, thank you, Miguel. Really good. Okay, right now, Carlos Alfonso, this one.
It is such a creative program.
Okay, in Spanish.
Eso es tan importante para crear un programa.
Okay. Sin importante. Okay, good. Acá se, es un... What? Es un programa muy creativo. Es un programa muy creativo. In this case, o tan creativo, right? Pero nosotros lo asimilamos más a nuestra cultura como muy. Okay, in this case... La estructura no falla. Aquí tiene un article. This is an adjective. This is a noun, right? Ahí estamos. Really good. Okay, we're gonna continue with this. Marlon, this one.
It is so important to check the reports.
Okay, now in Spanish.
Esto es muy importante chequear los reportes.
Yeah, really good, nice. Thank you, Marlon, es muy importante. As you see here, ya es an adjective. De acá no tenemos un nombre ni nada de eso. Acá ya hay una división. We add something else. Okay, really good. Right now, we're gonna go with Marlon again. Marlon, continue, please.
Gives such... A significant investment.
Okay, pretty good. Go ahead. Translate it.
Era muy significativo. Era una investigación muy significativa.
Mm-hmm. Investment. What does it mean, investment?
Invento. Oh. Pagar.
When you go to a company and you put your money to work in that company.
Inversión.
Yeah, really good. Nice, cool. Yeah, sure. Congratulations. Me sirvieron ahí, the body language. Okay, Marla. Era una muy, una inversión.
Una inversión muy significante.
Yeah, muy significativo. Okay. Okay, nice. As you see, the same structure, right? Such plus an article plus an adjective plus a noun, la la la, right? Okay, here. Okay, right now, this one. Let me see, William. This one.
The projects were so well made.
Okay, good.
Translation sería... los proyectos estaban muy bien hechos o algo así.
Okay, sure. Thank you, William. It's really good. Okay, estaba muy bien hecho. Okay, nice. Jorge, continue with this one.
The report was such a you for two before,
yeah.
Los reportes eran muy
útiles,
una gran herramienta muy útil. Eran una herramienta muy útil.
Antes, okay. Una herramienta muy útil, yeah.
Okay.
Really good, Jorge. As you see, the same structure, right? Article, adjective, and so on. Okay, thank you, Jorge. Nice work. And the last one, I'm going to help you write. Our ideas were so imaginary. Nuestras ideas fueron muy o tan imaginativas, right? Ya se imaginan todos juntos pensando solo cosas geniales, right? Okay, más en un fin de semana. Okay, very good. And the last one that we have is, Mary, can you help me, please?
And the last product was such a big
success. Okay.
El último producto era muy. What is success?
Success is like an éxito.
Un gran éxito. Okay. El producto fue un gran éxito.
Un gran éxito. Okay, as you see, such plus an article, plus an adjective, plus nouns or verb, whatever, right? Okay, good. Here we go. Everybody understand this? Do you have any questions so far? Questions? No questions? Okay, good. We're gonna continue with this. If you don't have any question, we're gonna put into practice the previous knowledge, right? So and such. ¿Cuándo vamos a utilizar so? When we're gonna use so?
Cuando lleva un adjetivo.
Yeah, and that's it, right? A caso especial que sea many.
Que sean incontables.
Yeah, countable and uncountable.
Countable.
Yeah, really good. And what about such? When we are going to use such?
En todos los demás.
That's right. That's the best answer that I ever heard. Es la mejor respuesta que he escuchado. Take it for me, right? La voy a tomar y la voy a utilizar en algunas ocasiones. Okay, nice. Such, para todas las demás, adjetivo, más an article, plus a noun, y otros complementos. Okay, let's get started with this. We're gonna have 6 examples. Okay, who wants to start with the first one? Just you have to add so or such. Okay, who wants to start? Raise your hands. May teacher. Only one student, right?
Number one is so.
No? Are you sure? Can you read it, Carlos?
Yes. Yes, so.
Okay. Can you read the whole sentence?
It's good to know the cash flow. They are so important.
Important, yeah. Important. Yeah, sure. Como que si estamos haciendo de esos, how do you say the people who are the big boss or big no sé qué, que cantan así con la garganta, right? ¿Ya los han escuchado? Okay. Así vamos a decir este. Important.
Important.
Yeah.
Important.
Okay, intenten decirlo lo más rápido. They are so important.
They are so important. So important. So
important. Yeah, sure. Okay, nice. Thank you. Okay, the second one. Yeah, cool. Who wants to do it?
Yes, Sosh.
Sosh.
Sosh. Okay, are you sure?
Yes.
Yes, okay, Mary, can you help me to read it, please?
The architect is such a creative one.
Okay, creative
woman.
Okay,
women. Women.
Yeah, good, nice, very good. Thank you. Okay, Gabriela, can you tell me a name for your classmates?
Okay, wait. Fabricio.
Okay, Fabricio.
Okay. So?
Ah, okay. So. Yeah, thank you, Fabricio. Can you help me to read?
Wireless internet access is so convenient.
Okay, convenient.
Convenient.
Okay, really good. Wireless. What is wireless?
Wi-Fi.
Okay, yeah, sure, it's Wi-Fi. Okay, I like your answer, right? pero así how can I say this? Literalmente, ¿qué significa wireless? I would like to teach you something new today.
¿Sin cables?
Sin cables, muy bien, Jorge. ¿Y solo los cables, cómo sería, Jorge?
Wire,
yeah, really good. Si bien esa palabra es compuesta, esa compuesta. Wire es cable. Wireless es sin cable o inalámbrico. En este caso, el Wi-Fi que dice Fabrizio. Okay, yeah, sure. Number four. Okay, who wants to do number four? Fabrizio, tell me a name.
Okay. Ya vino Marvin, no.
No, Marvin.
No. Miguel.
Okay, Miguel.
All the environment we create are popular.
Okay. Miguel, can you repeat that again, please? Inventions.
Okay. All the inventions we created are so popular.
So popular. So yeah. Popular. Yeah. Nice. Thank you, Miguel. Good job. Miguel, can you give me a name?
William Alexander.
Okay, William. Go ahead, William. Okay, William, can you turn on the microphone, please?
Okay. The computer was such a significant invention.
Yeah, really good. Nice. You sound like a gringo, Williams. Thank you so much. Okay. William, give me a name. The last one.
¿Cómo?
Give me a name from your classmate.
Vamos a ver. Jorge Alberto.
Okay, Jorge. Nice.
Checking your financial statement was so difficult before.
Okay, really nice. Let's see. So or such?
Such.
Okay, Jorge. In this case, you can use both. En este caso, podemos utilizar ambas, así que está muy genial. Ambas, ¿por qué?
Yo pensé que era so porque es difficult, es como se llama adjetivo. Before no es nombre.
Yeah, I know. But in this case, Jorge, we can use both. Podemos utilizar ambos. ¿Por qué? If we add a complement here, we can use such. If we not, right? But right now, before, as you said, we can use so. So is the right answer to this. Okay, thank you, Jorge. En este caso, Jorge tiene mucha razón. So es la respuesta más correcta. As he said, before is not a noun. Pero puse such porque iba a agregar un complement, right? Okay, Jorge. I'm just kidding, right? So is the right answer. Thank you. Okay, guys, I know that you understand everything about so and such, but right now we're gonna train your listening skill, right? Tenemos que entrenar ahí nuestro oído, nuestra audición, así que let's get a start with this. Okay, thank you. There we go. Good evening, Rodrigo. How are you?
Hi, teacher.
How are you today?
I'm fine. Thank you.
Nice. Okay, let me see. Give me a minute, wait. Okay. I'm sorry. Okay, here we go. Here we go, right? Okay, we're gonna try to listen an audio. And the audio will be about financial statements. Audio will be about financial statements. El audio será acerca de situaciones financieras, así que pay full attention to this and try to understand this audio. Okay, here we go.
Can I borrow a few bucks until payday? I'm a little strapped for cash.
Yeah, I guess. But I'm pinching pennies myself, and you still owe me $20 from last week.
Oh.
And Mom and your friend Ron said that you borrowed money from them this past week.
Oh, yeah.
And how are things going anyway?
Well, not very well. To be honest, I'm really in a hole, and I can't seem to make ends meet these days.
What do you mean? I thought you landed a great job recently, so you must be loaded.
Well, I do have a job, but I've used my credit cards to pay off a lot of things recently, but now I can't seem to pay the money off.
Do you have a budget? I mean, how do you keep track of your income and expenses?
Well, when my money runs out, I come to you, of course.
Great.
No, but I guess I should have some financial plan.
Well, let's see if I can help you. How much money do you spend on your apartment?
I pay $890 on rent for the studio apartment downtown, not including utilities and cable TV, but the place has an awesome view of the city.
$890? Why are you paying through the nose for such a small place when you could find a cheaper one somewhere outside of the downtown area?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay, how much money do you spend on food a month?
Well, I'm not really sure. I think I spend about $600.
$600?
Well, I go out to eat at least 4 times a week, so the expenses add up. I just don't enjoy eating alone, and I don't have a knack for cooking like you do.
Well, I can understand that, but perhaps you ought to buy some microwavable meals you could just prepare at home.
Well, I guess I could.
And entertainment?
Well, I spend a few dollars here and there on basketball, movie tickets, a concert or two, and ballroom dance lessons.
Exactly how much do you spend on all of these? Just a few dollars?
Well, about $400 or so.
Or so? No wonder you're having money problems. You just can't blow your money on things like that. And what about transportation?
Well, I commute to work every day in my new sports car, but I got a great deal and my monthly payments are only $450 a month. Come outside and take a look. We can go for a spin.
No, I've heard enough. You've got to curb your spending or you'll end up broke. I suggest you get rid of your credit cards, cut back on your entertainment expenses, and sell your car.
Huh?
Take public transportation from now on.
Sell my car? I can't date without a car. What am I gonna say? Could you meet me downtown at the bus stop at 7? Come on!
And you need to create a budget for yourself and stick to it. And start with paying off your bills, starting with me. You owe me $50.
$50? Wait, I only borrowed $20 from you last week. How did you come up with 50?
Financial consulting fees. My advice is at least worth 30.
Okay, nice. You got it, right? Everything is clear, teacher. Okay, good. Okay, basically the first sentence that we have to complete is, the man is speaking with his friend, mom, or sister? Okay. The second one will be, how do you describe the man's current situation? He is in debt and is trying to borrow money. He has a lot of expenses, including student loans. He has a decent job, but he's looking for a new one. Okay, number three, right? Which sentence best describes the man's dining practices? He's big. He doesn't know how to cook very well. He prefers to eat alone. He tries to go out to eat every night. The man's apartment is, ¿cómo es el apartamento? An apartment downtown with free parking. Un apartamento en el centro de la ciudad con un parque, con un parqueo gratis. And a small place with a nice view of the city. O es un lugar pequeño. An spacious apartment that includes cable TV, right? Okay, por acá nos vamos a ir guiando. Okay, and the woman suggests that the man. ¿Qué le sugiere la chica a este hombre? Get rid of his car to save money. Stop spending money on entertainment. Be careful when using his credit card. Okay, veamos acá. We're gonna listen again. And right now, I know that you are going to understand perfectly, right? Okay, here we go.
Can I borrow a few bucks until payday? I'm a little strapped for cash.
Yeah, I guess. But I'm pinching pennies myself, and you still owe me $20 from last week. And Mom and your friend Ron said that you borrowed money from them this past week.
Oh, yeah.
And how are things going anyway?
Well, not very well. To be honest, I'm really in a hole, and I can't seem to make ends meet these days.
What do you mean? I thought you'd landed a great job recently, so you must be loaded.
Well, I do have a job, but I've used my credit cards to pay off a lot of things recently, but now I can't seem to pay the money off.
Do you have a budget? I mean, how do you keep track of your income and expenses?
Well, when my money runs out, I come to you, of course.
Great.
No, but I guess I should have some financial plan.
Well, let's see if I can help you. How much money do you spend on your apartment?
I pay $890 on rent for the studio apartment downtown, not including utilities and cable TV, but the place has an awesome view of the city.
$890? Why are you paying through the nose for such a small place when you could find a cheaper one somewhere outside of the downtown area?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay, how much money do you spend on food a month?
Well, I'm not really sure. I think I spend about $600.
$600?
Well, I go out to eat at least four times a week, so the expenses add up. I just don't enjoy eating alone, and I don't have a knack for cooking like you do.
Well, I can understand that. But perhaps you ought to buy some microwavable meals you could just prepare at home.
Well, I guess I could.
And entertainment?
Well, I spend a few dollars here and there on basketball and movie tickets, a concert or two, and ballroom dance lessons.
Exactly how much do you spend on all of these? Just a few dollars?
Well, about $400 or so.
Or so? No wonder you're having money problems. You just can't blow your money on things like that. And what about transportation?
Well, I commute to work every day in my new sports car. But I got a great deal and my monthly payments are only $450 a month. Come outside and take a look. We can go for a spin.
No, I've heard enough. You've got to curb your spending or you'll end up broke. I suggest you get rid of your credit cards, cut back on your entertainment expenses, and sell your car. Take public transportation from now on.
Sell my car? I can't date without a car. What am I going to say? Could you meet me downtown at the bus stop at 7? Come on!
And you need to create a budget for yourself and stick to it. And start with paying off your bills, starting with me. You owe me $50.
$50? Wait, I only borrowed $20 from you last week. How did you come up with 50?
Financial consulting fees. My advice is at least worth 30.
Okay, nice. Now you got it, right? Not yet? More or less? Okay, good. Okay, unfortunately, we don't have enough time. Así que we're going to answer these sentences, right? The equations. The first one, the man speaking with his?
Sister.
Sister. Everybody's agree?
Sister. Yes.
Sister.
Yes. Sister.
His friend?
Friends? Okay, his friends. Okay. No. Okay. Okay, here we go. Who said sister, raise your hand. Okay, good. Okay, that's good. And what about friends? Yes, me and Jorge, right? Okay, that's good. Okay, we're gonna go with sister. Here we go. Yeah, sure. Nice, congrats, right? Okay, the second one. How do you describe the man's current situation? ¿Cómo describimos esa situación de este muchacho? Okay. First one, second.
First one.
His one.
First one? Okay.
First one.
Okay, everybody's agreed. Who said first one? Raise your hand. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, that's good. Okay, good. Second one? The teacher. Okay, we're gonna go with first one. Okay, here we go. Cross your fingers like this, right? Okay, nice. Yeah, sure. Really good. Nice. Okay, number three, right? Okay, number three. Which sentences best describe the men's dining practice? ¿Cuál de estas oraciones describe mejor las prácticas o cómo cena esta persona?
Two.
You prefer to eat alone.
Okay, you prefer to eat alone. Okay, everybody's agree? Just raise your hands. Yeah, right. Okay, good. Okay. Okay, here we go. Oh, no. Number one. He doesn't know how to cook very well. So that's why he tries to go eat every night. Como sabe cocinar bien, él va a comer casi a diario fuera. Okay, good. Number four, I think. The men's apartment is, ¿cómo es el apartamento?
A spacious apartment that includes cable, TV.
Okay, did you hear TV, right? Okay, good. Number three, everybody's okay.
Number two.
Number two, small place. Okay, okay, good.
Small place. With a nice view of the city.
Okay, cool.
Number three.
Mm. Two, three. Okay, who said number two? Raise your hands. One,
two.
Okay, who said number two? Number three, raise your hands. Okay, number three, right? Here we go.
Hey. Okay. La única que tenía buena yo.
Pero no.
No, no le tiene fe. Es su partner. Sí. Okay. But the last one. The woman suggests that the man. La chica sugiere que el hombre.
One. Number one.
One. Okay. The ride of this car to ceremony.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah, sure.
Yes.
Yeah, very nice. You get 3 out of 5, right? This is like 6 or 7. Good job, right? It basically, it was a hard listening for today's class, but we have to do it. So thank you, guys. You did it really. Like it. Okay, nice. Cool. So, fortunately, we have to continue with today's class. We're gonna go to the class. Okay, there we go. There we go, guys. We got class. Okay, here we go. We get a cash flow, income statement, equity statement, balance sheet, right? Balance sheet. Okay. What we're gonna do here, we have to understand this meaning of this, each one of these. But unfortunately, we don't have enough time to do this activity. We only mention the meaning of this. What does it mean, cash flow?
Yeah.
What about this one? Income statement. Income statement. What does it mean, this one?
Three.
I'm sorry, Carlos. Income.
Number three.
Estado de resultados.
Okay, okay. This one, income statement. Yeah. Really good, thank you, Gabriela. Estado de resultado. That's the meaning. Solo el significado por un momento. Okay, this one, number C. Letter C, I'm sorry. Equity statement. Equity statement. What does it mean? Equity statement. Okay.
Es como capital, patrimonio, pero... ahí sería como estado de capital, pero en español lo usamos como estado de patrimonio.
Okay, okay.
El balance general.
Okay, I'm sorry, Miguel.
No, me equivoqué con la D. Lo siento.
Okay. Es bad. Yeah, sure. Es básicamente, Gabriela, lo que nos dice eso. En español se utiliza diferente que en inglés, es decir, la traducción, right? Equity statements, este es como el patrimonio. Ahí,
activos.
Activos, yes. Basically, it's like activos. Aunque activos, vamos a ver que tenemos otra palabra especial para activos. Ok, ese sería patrimonio, right? Ok, balance sheet.
Balance general.
Balance general.
Really good. Unfortunately, we don't have enough time to complete this exercise, so that's why we're gonna continue with this. Okay, before to say to do that activity, we're gonna try to listen this the right pronunciation of this word, right? Cash flow, income statement. Equity statement, balance sheet. Okay, good. You don't have any problem when you pronounce these words? No? No problems? Okay, good. If you don't have any problem, students, right now we're gonna discuss, but in group, right? These following ideas, right? You have to share your opinion and given reasons about this. For example, we're gonna talk about incomes, outcomes, fire people, profit of your own company. Let's see this. What does it mean, income? Solo incomes. Vamos a ir step by step. Incomes.
Ingresos.
Ingresos, yeah, really good. Ingresos significa incomes. What about outcomes?
Egresos.
Egresos, really good. Egresos, right? Lo que gastamos, lo que se gasta en una empresa. Fire people.
Despedir personal.
Yeah, really good. When somebody, you know, le dan en la neck right ahí. You know,
come. In December.
Yeah, sure. Blacklist. Okay. What about profit?
Profit. Utilidades.
Ganancia.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, sure. Son ganancias. Really good ganancias. Okay. Right now, what we're going to do? Of your own company, students, you can... put your own company as an example. Pueden poner su propia compañía como ejemplo, o su caso personal. You're going to talk about incomes, outcomes, fire people, profit. How come? Let's see. For example, I can ask to Fabricio, Fabricio, what do you think about your incomes? ¿Qué piensas acerca de tus ingresos? Y Fabricio me va a decir, ah, teacher, I think my incomes, you know, is really high. And I receive a lot of money from my company. Y me comienza a describir todas las ganancias que recibe, si es a nivel personal. O, mire, teacher, mi compañía gana mucho dinero, y así allá, y yo también. Ok, luego, the same questions. What do you think about outcomes? Outcomes. Y ahí, yo creo que los egresos son más que los ingresos. So, right. Ok. Y luego podemos preguntar, Williams, what do you think about fire people? ¿Qué opinas de cuando despiden personas, el personal? Y ahí Williams, okay, I think teacher is sad, but sometimes they have to do it. Pero algunas veces se tiene que hacer, right? Y ahí me da una explicación breve y precisa. Then you continue asking, what do you think about profit? And then you're going to answer, I think profit is nice for a company. And so on, right? Yep. Okay, basically, you're going to ask 1, 2, 3, 4 questions. But the questions are easy, right? Because just you have to add this one. Solo vamos a agregar, what do you think about incomes? What do you think about outcomes? And so on. Lo que me interesa es que den su opinión de cada una de estas cosas. I think this and this and this. I think this and this and this. Acá pueden cambiar. In my opinions, what I think, I thought. Pueden cambiar la palabra de inicio por cualquier otra. Okay, you got it right? Yep. Sure. Okay, we're going to work in groups. Vamos a trabajar en grupos para que se puedan apoyar entre ustedes. Así que here we go. Good luck. Don't be shy. Practice each other. Okay, good luck. Okay. Go ahead. You have to give opinions about incomes, outcomes. What else? Let me see. Incomes, outcomes. Let's see, fire people and profit. Okay. Okay, Merlin, are you there, Merlin? Merlin? Okay. Okay, Daisy, are you there, Daisy? You have to work with your group and share your idea, each other. We're gonna talk about incomes, outcomes, fire people and profit. Okay, we're gonna wait for a while. Daisy is a little bit sick. She's sick right now. That's why she is listening to this class. Okay. Okay, very good. Okay, basically this is gonna be the exercise that we're gonna have today class. The students need to talk about what you think about these four things: incomes, outcomes, fire people, profit. Okay. Okay. Do you need help?
Ahí estamos.
Okay.
Pensando.
You're thinking about it.
Pregunta, teacher, ¿verdad que podemos hacerlo de nuestros ingresos personales también, verdad?
Yeah, sure. Remember that when you work
sobre nuestro trabajo, ¿verdad? En mi caso, que más que todo mis ingresos dependen de lo que recibo de salario en la empresa.
Yeah, sure. Recuérdese que sus propios ingresos son su propia compañía, right? If you see like that. So, sí, puede ser sus propios ingresos, like your salary, or your own company. O si tiene su propia compañía, o si trabaja para una compañía y sabe esos datos, nice. Okay, cool. Yeah, and remember, we're gonna talk about incomes, outcomes, fire people, and let me see, profit, right? Profit es lo que más nos incentiva, y that's our motivation, profit, right? Okay, cool. Okay, guys, continue working, so I'm gonna go to another group. Thank you.
The incomes are
how are you guys?
Hello.
Are you working?
Yeah,
sure. Do you have any questions?
Ahorita.
No. Oh, right. Okay, good. Cool, nice. Okay, continue working like that. I'm gonna go to another group. Thank you.
Okay.
Hello guys, how are you?
Hi teacher.
Everything is clear?
Excuse me. Question. Vamos a formular cuatro preguntas con las cuatro, bueno, palabras que nos dijo: income, outcome, fire people, and profit.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, the four questions, but the most important point will be the answer, your opinion. For example, I said, Carlos Enrique, what do you think about profit? For example, right? And Carlos Enrique said, teacher, I think profit is the best part of a company, because we receive money, because we can buy many things like this and this and this. Y comienza a explicar, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's clear, Carlos Mejía?
Yes, teacher, thank you.
Okay, welcome. Tienen que trabajar la pregunta y la respuesta. Okay, la pregunta porque okay. Van a hacer al compañero, y the answer because you have to.
O sea que no solamente vamos a dar una respuesta corta, sino que una breve explicación.
If you can give a brief explanation, will be fine. Si puede dar una breve explicación, será mejor. Yep. Si no, con una respuesta no tan corta, will be cool too. Sería genial también.
Por ejemplo, decir, ¿qué piensas sobre los ingresos? Pregunta. I think it's the priority for stability of the company.
Okay, yeah, it could be an answer.
Is correct?
Yeah, it's correct. Right.
Okay.
Cool. Like this. Okay, here you got the incomes, outcomes, five people, profits. Ingresos, egresos, despedir personal, la parte más triste, profits. Y la más alegre.
Ganancias.
Ganancias. Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome. What about you, Carlos Enrique? Everything is clear? Okay, Carlos Enrique, todos aquí. Hola. Everything is clear?
No, estamos en lo mismo.
Okay, okay. Okay, that's good. Questions?
No.
No questions.
No. Thank you, teacher. Thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah. Okay, continue working. I'm gonna go to another group. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Welcome.
Hello, hello.
Teacher.
Hello, teacher.
Hello, how are you?
Very good.
Very good, just working. Just chilling out. I don't know if you have a question.
Por el momento yo no, teacher.
Yo sí tengo una pregunta, teacher. Si yo pongo una suposición, okay. Por ejemplo, si nosotros, bueno, está bien si yo puedo decir maybe if we were in this situation.
Maybe if we were. Yeah, sure.
Sí, sí.
Yeah.
Gracias, teacher.
Okay, you're welcome. What about you, Tatiana? Questions?
No sé. No sé si está bien, cómo contesté.
Okay.
Nos hemos repartido una cada uno y la última la vamos a contestar los tres. Para que sea más rápido.
Ok, nice. It's okay.
A mí me corresponde, what do you think about outcomes? Mm-hmm. In my opinion, the expenses of the company are important to generate profits. It is like it. To inversión.
Investment.
Sí.
Yeah.
Investment.
Okay, investment. Okay, cool. Nice. Okay, like this is okay. Okay, very good. Okay, guys, if you don't have any questions, I'll see you in a moment, right? Okay.
Okay.
Ahí viene. Holiday. Bueno.
Are you ready?
Decimos.
Soso, teacher, soso.
Soso, soso.
Okay, that's good. Okay, if you're ready, let's get a start with this, and I would like to hear you, right? Go ahead.
Okay.
Fabricio,
okay. Okay. Uno solo se va a preguntar y uno solo va a responder, ¿verdad? Sí, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh. You can ask each other. Tienen que preguntarse.
Ah, vaya, por eso. Entonces, ¿me preguntas? Yo respondo y después me
sabes. Fabricio, what do you think income?
In my case, the income of the company is very good. Due the to many clients.
Okay. You answer. You question. Tú haces la pregunta, Fabricio.
Ah, okay.
You ask.
Okay.
You ask.
Jorge, what do you think about incomes?
Okay. My opinion, my outcome are very high. Example, in this year, my electric bill is up each month.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. William, what you think for the people?
Ahorita, bueno, en relación con mi empresa en este caso.
Okay.
I think they have sometimes been successful because they have justified to service.
Okay, that's good.
Creo que a veces, como digo, a veces han sido justificados, ¿verdad? Creo que ellos considero que no han despedido a nadie porque así han querido, al menos en ese aspecto ahí han sido justificados. Creo que sí, han habido compañeros que se pasaron de las manos.
Okay, continue asking each other.
In my case, the freed people, this is a something that I not like very much. Okay. But I shall do down an occasion for the good of the company.
Okay.
In my case, it's very sad, but it's so necessary. When the people retire or people don't do your work.
Okay. Yeah, sure. Nice. Okay. Ask it.
Okay. William, what do you think about the profits?
They are excellent. Although there are good months and some regular. Porque le dije que la verdad es que hay meses buenos y hay unos que han sido regulares.
Okay.
The profit is good cuando hay buena ganancia, ¿verdad? O sea, hay meses que la ganancia ha sido bastante bien.
In my case, the profit is very good. More in times or high season, Christmas, Holy Week, Holy Day.
Okay.
And today was nice. The whole year was a holy year.
High season.
Yeah.
in my world, this year is don't have profit for coronavirus. It is so hard because many clients don't and don't go the bank.
Okay. Yeah, sure. Yeah, that's true. Remember that with the coronavirus, you know, everybody, you know, fall, right? But as a gift, we are still alive. Estamos vivos y eso es nice, the best.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's profit. It's ganancia.
That's our profit. Really good. Okay, thank you guys. Continue practice if you want. If you want to talk about your job, you can do it, but in English, right? Okay.
Okay.
Thank you. Guys.
About outcome.
I think the outcomes will be more compared to last year for the product activities.
Repítamelo.
I think the outcomes will be more compared to the last year for their productive activities.
Okay.
Ya ahora, teacher.
Yeah, sure. Are you ready?
Maybe. I guess.
I hope.
Okay. Ah, pues le pero él va a preguntar, Miguel.
Okay.
La primera. Okay. Miguel, what do you think about incomes?
I think the company incomes was so low for the pandemic.
Okay, what do you think about outcomes?
I think the outcomes will be more compared to the last year.
Okay, what do you think about fire people?
Many people will be fired because the low activity economic.
Okay. Yeah.
What do you think about profit?
I think the profit of the company will be the same the last year. Are the same.
Ready? Nice, teacher. Okay.
Ahora, no sé cómo
ahora yo le haré las preguntas.
Vale.
What do you think about the incomes?
I think that the incomes are money that companies receive for exchange products or service. And the incomes are so necessary for economic activities and fulfilling obligations.
What do you think about the outcomes?
In my opinion, the companies have to control that their expenses or outcomes are so necessary to economic activities.
Okay, and what do you think about the fire people?
I think that the fire people are such bad situations, but sometimes but sometimes the company have to do for different reasons.
Okay, and what do you think about the profit?
I think that the mass companies want profits, and this is result of such good resource management.
Okay. Ahora hagamos las a José Ángel las preguntas.
Vale. ¿Te las hago yo?
Si quiero se dos y dos yo.
Bye. José, what do you think about incomes?
In my case, the company receives more income than outcomes is so important for that the company continues your economic activity.
Okay. What do you think about outcomes?
The outcome is low for the company.
Okay.
Okay. What do you think about the fired people?
The fired people, I think that is so difficult for the person.
Okay. And what do you think about the profit?
I think that profit so much for me, patrono.
Okay.
Okay, really nice work. I like it. Thank you. That was awesome, right? Fue bastante, bastante genial. Sonaron muy avanzados, así que I like it.
Gracias, teacher.
You're improving a lot. And remember, if you can continue practice with this, it will be fine, right? Okay, thank you, guys. You can continue to talk about your job, your vacations, your company, but in English, right? Okay, see you in a minute.
See you.
Okay.
Mi hijo se llama también. Está.
Ah, I'm sorry.
Está discutiendo ahí por la otra.
Okay. Hello. Did you finish?
Finish, teacher.
Okay, yeah, nice. I would like to hear you right now. Go ahead.
Preguntamos, bueno, si quiere inicie usted, Carlos, si yo continúo o viceversa, como a usted le parezca.
Inicio. What do you think about incomes?
I think it's the priority for the stability of a company.
Right. What do you think about outcomes?
Outcomes.
In my company, what is necessary to be working?
I think in my company. But what do you think about profits?
I think that with a lot of them, I am doing well.
What do you think about fire people?
It is a decision that I wore my glass with all this deserve to work.
I am very happy. Good night.
Good night.
Okay, nice. Right now, you're going to switch the roles, right? Carlos Mejia asks to Carlos Enrique. Una pregunta de Carlos,
okay.
Carlos
Enrique. Okay. What do you think about the incoming?
I think in the priority for the study of company.
What do you think about outcome?
I think in my company it is necessary to be working.
What do you think of the profit?
I think that with a lot of demand, I am doing well.
What do you think of the fire people?
I think it is a decision that would be made last we all deserve to work.
I am very happy. Good night.
Okay, nice work. Okay, thank you guys. You did a really, really good work. I like it. You can continue practice each other, you know, about your job, about vacations, about whatever you want, but in English, please. Okay, see you in a minute. I'm gonna go to another group. Thank you so much. Nice work.
Okay, thank you, teacher. Thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Siempre llama
siempre le reembolsan en los dividendos del siguiente año.
Ya casi. Nosotros le decimos en español a Rodrigo y ya lo traduce.
No, yo creo que ya estuvo, ya está en la última, solo que no lo hemos practicado, así que vamos a ir como a capela.
Okay, go ahead. I would like to hear you.
Vaya, hacemos si gustan lo que hicimos cada uno.
Sí, cabrón. Que empieza ahí Tatiana.
Vaya, entonces le pregunto a Tatiana para que haga el suyo. What do you think about outcomes?
In my opinion, the expenses of the company are important. They generate profit. It's like it to investment.
Yeah, in this case, Tatiana, link to investment.
Link.
It's mean que enlaza. Como el link que nosotros buscamos en internet. Vamos a buscar el link. Ponemos el link y nos tira a un dominio en específico. Like es this one. Right? Okay, link.
Link.
Yeah, link. Continue.
Okay, Carlos. What do you think about incomes?
I think the company's incomes are so good. When the product is good, it can obtain up to double its cost. It also makes a good income for the seller if he has many clients.
Clients, yes.
But ahí, teacher, la consulta era que si es lo mismo utilizar acá, clients o customers.
Customer. You can use whatever you want. El que se le haga más fácil. Customer, clients, the same.
Ah, okay. Thank
you.
You're
welcome.
Rodrigo, what do you think about fired people?
In my case, I think that is necessary. Maybe if we were in this situation, we were a little bit worried, and it's normal. I'm going to give you an example. If you have a company and you see someone working bad or every day angry with everybody, you're not going to be happy because it's going to give you problems. So you have to think to do something. I've never been fired, and I hope it's not going to happen.
Yeah, perfect. Good.
What do you think about profit?
Earning a profit is important to a small business because profitability impact if a company can secure financing from a bank.
From a bank, okay, yeah, really good. Thank you. Nice work. Excellent work, students. Amazing. That's awesome. You sound very, very nice, right? Okay, only this word, linked and think. Carlos, ahí, think. Carlos, can you read this question again?
Think.
Okay, the whole question. Toda la pregunta, Lea.
What do you think about outcomes?
Outcomes, okay, really good. Muy bien, perfect. This is think. What do you think about outcomes? Yeah, thank you, Carlos Alfonso.
Okay.
Work, excellent. De todas las palabras ahí, solo fueron una que dio problema. Ahí a Carlos, Tatiana, Rodrigo, excellent. Really nice work. Okay, thank you guys. That was awesome. And we're gonna go back to the main session, right? Okay, see you there.
Okay.
Okay, everybody practice, right, about your own company in English. You talk about your job, you talk about your company, your profit, the best things in our job, right? Okay, we're gonna wait for the rest of the students. Yeah, very good. Okay. I don't know if you have a questions, students, question about today class. No questions? Okay. Okay, we're gonna give a minute to this. Yeah, sure. Okay, give me a minute. Yeah, very good. Okay, if you don't have any questions, I'm gonna pass the attendance list as the last time for today class. When you hear your name, please say present teacher, I'm here, right? Wendy, Sarai, Bonilla, Ortoñez. Okay, Wendy, are you there? Wendy, write a message that she got a internet problem connections. Tiene un pequeño problema de conexión. Nos escribió allá el chat. Así que, so Wendy was here, but she cannot say present. Okay, Rodrigo Alexander Maravilla Vázquez.
Present teacher.
Okay, thank you, Rodrigo. Marvin Ernesto. No, right. Marvin today was not here. Okay, very nice. Yeah, sure. Okay, did you finish the homework that we have on the platform?
No.
Yo siempre tengo el mismo problema, teacher, aquel que le escribí que no me deja la última parte todavía.
Ok, alguien que ya lo haya, haya superado ese problema.
En la última, fíjate bien que tenga los puntos, porque a mí así me pasó una vez, puse el, no le puse el punto y por eso me ponía mal la oración.
Al final.
Ajá, al final, en, el final punto, en todos.
Ok, Rodrigo, you have to...
Sí, es cierto, ahorita acabo de hacer uno y cabal, ahí está.
Ok, gracias. Yeah. We are a team, right? Somos un equipo. Así
gracias, gracias.
Okay. Yo a veces también en la primera letra vaya en mayúscula, cositas así, el apóstrofe o los puntos, bien complicado, porque a veces uno lo está escribiendo bien, pero le sale error, pero quizás el punto está mal. Piensa que lo escribió mal.
Yo en la tarea 9, en la tercera pregunta, no me la agarra. Okay. Intenté de todas formas.
Ok, José Ángel. If you can send to the WhatsApp group, you can do it. We want to do something. Vamos a hacer algo ahí. Mándalo al WhatsApp para ver qué podemos, cómo podemos ayudar, right?
Mandar okay. la foto de la pantalla.
Vale.
De pantalla, acá.
Yeah, sure. Okay, guys. At the end, you know, our profit is that we're gonna improve our knowledge. Ahí estamos metiendo la respuesta correcta. Esa es la respuesta correcta y no nos da la respuesta correcta. Es un entrenamiento para que nunca se nos olvide, right?
Oh my God.
Okay, that's good. Okay, unfortunately, we don't have enough time. That's it for today, class. Thanks for being here, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye bye, take care, and go to sleep.
Bye.
Bye, teacher.
Bye,
teacher. Good night. Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Take care. Go to sleep. Don't go to watch Netflix.
Free fire minimum.
Free fire.
Oh, bad for you. Okay, bye-bye, Mary.
Bye.
Nice to see you.